Top of the morning, good afternoon, and hello to all the coaches out there and to all the people out there. A hearty and healthy hello. All right, welcome to Club Fearless Weekly Inspirational Talk. And today, I want to talk about something that is so important, maybe the most important thing for anyone to do in their lives, whether they're a coach or whether you're out there in the world playing, enjoying, creating, stressing, planning, organizing, living life. This one thing is the most important thing that you could possibly do, especially if you want to be a Top Gun coach. Now, what is this one thing? Well, let me sip on my tea first. Ah, yes. Take the man out of Ireland, but you can't take the tea out of the man. Before I talk a little bit about this, I want to tell you my own little story of when I first started coaching back in 2012. I would sit at home for hours and hours on end, wondering, where do I get clients, and stressing and pulling my hair out. And if you've seen a picture of me lately, I don't have any hair. And I would sit in the office looking out the window like a sheep stuck in the headlights or a deer stuck in the headlights, wondering, where do I get clients? And I got so stressed about this that I couldn't come up with ideas. I would sit at home every day. This went on for, 3 years. You alone can do it, but you can't do it alone. Get help, coaches. Don't do this thing alone. It's impossible to build a coaching practice, a successful one, on your own. Get help. And so eventually the light went on and I got I hired Steve Chandler. After 3 years of trying to do it by myself and gone broke, I spent all my savings. I decided, you know what? I'm going to have to do something different. And what I decided to do, the light bulb went on, I decided to hire someone who already knew how to create a coaching practice. Now you would think, Durbit, duh. But it never occurred to me. I just went on Google and I talked to my other friends who were not making money at coaching. What are they doing? And they said, well, you have to get clients, you have to get target audience, you got to hunt high and low for your target, get a funnel, squash all the people into the funnel, squash them in there. And hopefully if you squash about 1,000 people in, one or two people will come out and they'll be your clients and pay you for coaching. Woohoo! Bring on the funnels. Didn't work. What I learned was it didn't work because service is the way to go for coaching practice. It's what I teach in Club Fearless, service, not selling. Give people an experience of coaching and the experience does the selling. Now you might be asking, we're getting to the topic, how do you give people an experience of coaching, Dermot, to where they go, wow, this coach is on it, this coach knows what I'm doing, this coach is speaking the same language, we're on the same page, holy moly, I don't know whether to hire this coach or marry them, they're brilliant. The thing that we've got to do as coaches, and when I met my coach, it was the first thing that he told me to do. What's this one thing that if you want to be a great coach, a Top Gun coach, I just love that I threw it in there because it was funny. You got to relax. I know it doesn't sound life-changing, does it? It doesn't sound like a Tony Robbins moment. No. It doesn't sound like your head's going to explode because that's the insight of the month. But yet that's what we got to do. We got to relax. Now, I used to teach coaching for many, many years at an international school. And one of the things I would always teach is, listening. But, conscious listening and strong listening and elephant listening. And level 3 listening. And if you're listening to that, you can kind of hear the forced in that, right? What I teach now in Club Fearless is very different. One of our classes every month is on just developing your coaching skills. Because I've learned that you need to develop your business building skills, you need to develop your coaching skills, and you need to have someone to support you to do all of that. That's why we created Club Fearless. And one of the things that I teach in there is relaxed listening. Not forced listening, not pushed listening. you're having a bowel movement, you wouldn't force yourself to have one, would you? No, you have to relax. Okay, I apologize for going on the bowel movement, but it's a really good, you know, metaphor, is you got to relax for things to move. Now, the law of attraction says, one of the things that I teach in Club Fearless also, that which is likened to itself is drawn. In other words, what you think about, you become. Or another way to think about it is you get what you think about, whether you want it or not. And so being relaxed, when we start to put the focus on being relaxed, more things come to us. I teach law of attraction classes. And the thing I tell coaches and regular Joes to do most, relax. It's the secret to this whole thing of coaching. Now, let me tell you why. Let me show you a few things that might be helpful to you. When you relax, the quality of your listening is better. When you relax, you're more curious about what the client is going through, how you might be able to help the client. When you're more relaxed, you have connection to intuition, better questions, which, by the way, better questions, you get a better life. You get relaxed questions. When you ask relaxed questions, there's more insight, there's more intuition, there's more wisdom, there's more intelligence in those questions. And as a result, they're more impactful to the client. So relaxed listening, relaxed curiosity, relaxed questioning is the way to go. We have two superpowers. One is listening, and the other is asking questions. When you have a relaxed coach, that will benefit the whole world. When you are a relaxed coach, that's going to benefit your coaching practice. When you're a relaxed coach, it's going to benefit your client's world. And, you know, if you look out into the world, relaxed people in general seem to benefit the whole world. Now, coach position is about being relaxed. I teach this all the time. I teach a very simple. Here's a really simple thing to do. If you want to get into coach position, because coach position is about being relaxed. It's setting the intention. It's setting yourself up for success before the session. How do you do that? The more relaxed you are, the more successful you'll be in the session. The more relaxed you are, the more the client will be relaxed. Have you ever gone to a session where you're tense and the client comes in and they're tense and you never get a contract, you never get anywhere in the session? And after the session, you ask yourself, God, did that go very well? The question we should be asking ourselves is, how relaxed am I before the session? How relaxed am I during the session? And if you like, how relaxed are you after the session? Because the more relaxed you are, the better you'll be as a coach. A Top Gun coach even. That's what I want to be, Dermot, is a Top Gun coach. Well, learn to relax. Now, think about it in this way. One of the things as coaches that we bring to the table is asking questions. And when we're relaxed in our body, we're able to ask questions that are powerful. I always tell the coaches that the best questions come out of the silence. You allow the silence to inform the next question, but you have to be relaxed for that. You have to know that, hey, I might not know what I'm doing as a new coach, if you're a new coach. But the more relaxed I am, the more access I have to questions that are going to benefit the client. I was going out to a meeting the other day, one of the biggest clients that I've ever gotten. And I was going out to the first meeting to meet their team and the CEO and the whole lot. And my partner said, hey, are you stressed? Are you anxious? And I thought to myself, no, I'm not. I'm very relaxed. And she said, well, how is that? This is a pretty big deal. And I said, you know what? I've practiced being relaxed. I've practiced giving my attention every day a little bit to being relaxed. I check in with myself. Here's something that you can do during the day. Check in before a session. How relaxed am I? On a scale of 1 to 10, 1 is not relaxed. 10 is, you know, I'm a baby blob. I'm a 5-month-year-old baby. I'm pretty relaxed. You know, the body is so relaxed. It's kind of how you want to be. Now, one of the things that I use in Club Fearless is the law of attraction. And I will say to the clients, look, or I'll say to the coaches, if you want to be more relaxed, if you want to be more beneficial, valuable, insightful, impactful to a client, by the way, that's what they pay you for. They don't pay you for personality, hair color, how you're dressed. They pay you for impact. And impact comes through relaxation. So one of the things that I talk to the coaches about during the day is, notice, how relaxed are you? Are you relaxed before a session? If not, one of the things you can do is, and I mentioned it earlier, I'll teach it to you, very simple. Sit in a chair, or you can stand, put your feet flat on the floor, and feel your feet flat on the floor like lead weights. Now, if you like, you can visualize or envision or see or hear or feel roots coming out of your feet down into the ground, called grounding exercise. You're grounding the energy, nervous energy that you might be feeling, into the ground. And then you take your dominant hand, right hand, left hand, put it over your heart, you know, that mass of meat over there to the left. Put your hand over your heart. And just take a moment to feel grateful for something, anything. Appreciate one little thing. Hey, I appreciate this moment, or appreciate that I got a new client, or appreciate that someone is a new client is willing to come and talk to me and have a session. Whatever it might be, take a minute to appreciate that. And that's all you got to do, is a minute or two. Feel your feet flat on the floor, ground your feet in the ground, connect to your heart, scientifically proven to make you feel better and to be more in touch with your intuition, your wisdom, and to insight. Very powerful little technique, takes 2 or 3 minutes. Do that once or twice throughout the day. Now, the other thing that I want to talk about here for a minute or two is belief. A lot of coaches believe that they can't do this thing called successful coaching practice, or they can't even do coaching. And as we know, a belief is just a thought that you keep thinking. So I'm going to encourage you coaches now to start to play with the idea that you don't need to control your thoughts. Law of Attraction says that which is likened to itself is drawn. What you get about, what you think about, you become, right? What you get, what you think about, whether you want it or not. And so one of the things that you can start to play with is, and again, this is not about controlling your thoughts. It's about starting to guide yourself to better feeling thoughts. Once or twice throughout the day, take a minute, just a minute, and start to guide yourself toward relaxed thoughts. Now you might think of, you might play with the idea of like, you know, I like the idea of being relaxed. I like the idea of seeing more clearly. And you can just talk to yourself before the session. I was gonna say during the session, but actually before the session is better, or afterwards. And this is a great way to set yourself up for success. This is a great way to be a Top Gun coach, because most coaches go into sessions, they haven't set an intention, they haven't grounded themselves, there's no coach position, they're not relaxed, and they go into a session, it goes sideways or south, and they wonder what the hell happened. So I'm going to encourage you to start to play with this idea. Belief is only a thought that you keep thinking. Start to change your beliefs, start to practice feeling good, start to practice feeling relaxed before a session. Now you can do it before a session, you can do it throughout the day. I typically do that little exercise about 3 times a day. I do it before a session, and sometimes I'll even do it during the session. I'll just put my feet flat on the floor. I'll ask myself, Dermot, are you relaxed in this moment? No, I'm pushing, I'm forcing, I'm caught up in trying to get a result for the client. Not my job as a coach. My job is to show up, to be relaxed, to ask questions, and to listen. That's my only job as a coach. When I went to my that big client the other day, biggest one I've ever gotten in my life, and been quite a few, and I was relaxed because I had practiced being relaxed. So you can practice being relaxed. Ask yourself during the day, you want to be a Top Gun coach? Ask yourself during the day, which thought feels better? Hey, I like the idea of being a relaxed coach. You start to move your thoughts in a feeling, in a better feeling direction. I like the thought. I like the thought of being a great coach. I like the thought of being a top coach. I like the thought of being a Top Gun coach. I like the thought of connected to more wisdom. I love the idea of being a coach with new clients. I love the idea of getting paid for clients. I love the idea of walking into a session and being completely relaxed within myself. I love the idea of being a wonderful, well-paid, prosperous, functioning, impactful, intuitive, great, professional, wise coach. I love the thought of being relaxed in a session. I love the idea of being relaxed in a session. Two more questions and then we'll complete. How can I relax more before a session? And which thought feels better to me? And just play with that, practice that throughout the day and see what happens. The more relaxed you are in a session, take a session and say, you know, I'm just gonna throw the results to the side and I'm just going to, the only intention I have for the session today is I'm not going to get a result. I'm just going to be relaxed, see what questions come, and I'm going to listen from a relaxed place. And that's all I'm going to do. You do those two things. Ask questions from a relaxed place, listen from a relaxed place. You, my dear coaches, will be a Top Gun coach. Until the next time, think big, have fun, stay curious. And we shall see you all down the road. Cheers.